He said, I'm even painting pictures of blues artists, you know, so it's nice that all these different areas and mediums, you know, I've been able to sort of use them all to try to get a deeper appreciation of the music. He's a blues
star. Ain't no need to make no big fuss. He's a blues star. Hey, man, you got a dollar for the bus. He's a blues star. I'm famous everywhere I go. He's a blues star. I'm the king of college radio. I'm a blue star, baby, but it don't bother me. I've opened up for B.B. King. I wear a diamond pinky ring. I get a suite at Motel 6. I play all the Little Walter's licks. I'm a blue star, baby, but it don't bother me. Sell the tapes and I'll put the gigs. Yeah, I've really paid my dues. I'll know that I've reached the top of the heap. But when they write me up in living blues,
he's a blue star.
I travel all across the land.
He's a blue star.
I got a rebuilt Chevy van.
He's a blue star.
Yeah, my career is really moving.
He's a blue star.
You know, I've even tied with the union. I'm a blue star, baby, but it don't bother me. Nah, it don't bother me.
Decided not to get a haircut when,
George W. Bush established his coup a few years ago. That's my form of protest. I decided I wasn't going to get my hair cut until a Democrat came back into the White House. So I may be tripping over it before that happens, but I hope not.
Now, when I get to heaven, I won't be filled with gloom. When St. Peter asks me what I want in paradise, I'm gonna say 650 and rooms.
He's a blue star.
Who needs money anyway?
He's a blue star.
There'll just be another bill to pay.
He's a blue star.
All the women want me between the covers.
He's a blue star.
How come they all got to look like grandmothers? I'm a blue star, baby, but it don't bother me.
You're listening to the Sunday Night Blues here on Jazz 88. My name's Tom Townsley. Hope you're enjoying the program. Up next, we have a cut by the Kingsnakes. And this will be sort of a blast from the past, the cut you're about to hear. She's Tough was the first radio hit the Kingsnakes had. Of course, originally a Jerry McCain song, also covered by the Fabulous Thunderbirds, who I believe were a pretty influential band for the Kingsnakes. But back in the mid to late 80s, the Kingsnakes definitely ruled their den. They ruled the blues scene here in central New York. Pete McMahon on harmonica, Terry Mulhauser on the guitar, Paul Arand on the bass, and Lou Maselli and or Mark Tifo on the drums. And they pretty much captured a crowd that went beyond the blues, hardcore blues crowd that was here already in central New York, following other bands from the past like Triple Shot or the Otis Lee Band. But the Kingsnakes managed to capture a broader audience, and the way it pretty much happened was they were playing at a club called Nappy's down on Salina Street, no longer there, and basically playing to an empty house for a long time, for several months anyway. And a New Times ad appeared, or an article rather, appeared about the music scene and some of the overlooked acts in town. There was a big ad about Nappies and about the Kingsnakes, and sure enough, as a result, at least in part of that article, the club began to fill up and people began to realize that this was a really fine blues band, a really tough sound, well-arranged tunes, a lot of fine originals as well. And along with the Kingsnakes came the birth of Blue Wave Records. They were the the first act that Greg Spencer recorded with Blue Wave, and because the band became so popular, Blue Wave as a label was able to be launched as well. Of course, later on, the Kingsnakes began touring outside the area and eventually went on the road for a while with John Lee Hooker and so forth. But they were really hot in those early days once they began to catch on. We're going to play a cut for you right now. Again, this was, I believe, the first song they were getting radio play from, and it's She's Tough, and you heard it right here at the Home of the Blues, Jazz 88.
You ought to see my baby when you walk down the street. She's upsetting everybody she meets. 23 in the waist, 38 in the hip. She got long black wavy hair and ruby red lips. She's tough. Ooh, she's tough. My baby's tough. She's rough and tough. And that's tough enough. She walked past the clock won't tell time. Walk through the college, professor loses mind. But she's tough. Ooh, she's tough. My baby's tough. She's rough and tough. And that's tough enough.
And they certainly had the right product, the right package. They were a very tight band, great arrangements. They'd obviously spent a lot of time honing their material. They put on a pretty high energy show. Not that any of them individually were really, you know, gymnastic types of performers. In fact, if anything, they had a somewhat stoic stage demeanor, but the music had such energy. I think it just managed to reach a lot of people at the right time. I'm sure that, you know, the popularity of the blues around town caused this program to be expanded from 2 hours to 4 hours, so the Kingsnakes may indeed have had some part to play in that, and hopefully this program had some part to play in you know, helping to popularize them as well.
General said to my baby, come here, sweetheart. You can stop a world war even before it starts. We know the enemy won't pull the trigger when they walk out on the front line and they see your fine figure, cause you're tough. Ooh, she's tough. My baby's tough. She's rough and tough. And that's tough enough. And that's tough enough. And that's tough enough. And that's tough enough.
Going to play something right now by my old band, Cold Shot. I can say that when I came back to Syracuse from Florida in 85, the Kingsnakes were just beginning to really, you know, prove to be one of the dominant forces on the music scene here. I had been playing some blues in a band down in Florida the previous few years, was just sort of getting my feet wet on the harmonica, and came back and saw that the Kingsnakes were doing really well, and figured, well, there's always room for one more band, so managed to work through several incarnations of the band, but put together the band Cold Shot, and we had a lot of fun playing primarily, our main clubhouse was Shifty's on Burnett Avenue, but we managed to have a little success, put some music out, and had a really good time. And we're going to play a cut that we recorded for Blue Wave right now. This is Todd Fitzsimmons on the vocals from 1988, I think. And the song's called Gotta Jones.
for you, baby. You look so doggone fine. I got a Jones for you, baby. Jones for you, love. I got a Jones for your tongue. I got a Jones for your kissing. I got a Jones for your tongue. I got a Jones for your bones. I'd like to make a real man rock.
But I came back up here from Florida. I was kind of itching to put a blues band together, and I went out and saw the Kingsnakes and watched them do a set one time, and went up to Pete McMahon during the break. Said, man, you guys sound really great, you know, doing some really good stuff. I don't know, I was in the middle of this wonderful panegyric of, you know, bestowing the praise, and he just turned around and walked away. And it kind of pissed me off a little bit. And I said, all right, I'm gonna put a blues band together myself. Now, of course, since then, Pete and I have become good friends, and I've told him that story. He said, man, I don't remember that. I was kind of in a haze in those days anyway, but I wish I'd been nicer to you, because then you wouldn't have put this band together. I went out and, you know, met a bunch of people, and the band went through a number of different incarnations until we finally got the one that really seemed to catch, which was the version with Todd Fitzsimmons, Morris Tarbell, who's played in a number of bands in town, and for my money is one of my favorite blues guitarists, one of the best rhythm guitarists around. And Todd, a very fiery good guitarist too, and we were really good buddies. Tom Parker on drums, and Dangerous Dan Triano on bass. And we had a lot of fun. We played Shifties quite a bit. We did some shows with James Montgomery. We opened up for Buddy Guy and Junior Wells and Johnny Winters and James Cotton and Ronnie Earl and Jimmy Rogers with Pine Top Perkins. In fact, Jimmy Rogers was, you know, like my house guest for a weekend. You know, we brought him out to do some shows, so we'd sit up till 7 in the morning after gigs, you know, drinking Irish whiskey, and I'd be putting on all these blues records of, you know, guys like this, Sonny Boy Williamson, and other people who were mythological figures in my mind. And he'd say, oh yeah, I remember one night he got drunk at such and such a club and did this and that, and, you know, they were all just like, you know, his pals from, you know, from the South Side there in Chicago, and told some great stories, and, you know, was certainly a big part of my blues education, you know. I think a lot of other blues bands sprang up because of the Kingsnakes, because people saw how well that music was going over. Although the better of the blues bands that sprang up, I think, sprang up because those people also loved blues music. And it was just catching on at that time in general. But the Kingsnakes were the first really popular blues band. They were the first ones to record, to have their own record out. The record did really well, and then, of course, eventually they were going on and touring with John Lee Hooker, playing with him at the Chicago Blues Festival, and really rode the wave for quite a while before, you know, internal factors eventually caused them to split up. But they really, you know, brought this town alive, and I think made it aware of blues. There had always been a sort of hardcore blues crowd before that, but the Kingsnakes really made a crossover, and so for that reason they're the sort of blues ambassadors, I guess, of Central New York. And a lot of the other things that have happened since probably wouldn't have happened without the success they had and the roads that they paved. Which, in order for there to be a scene, there would have to be just a lot of people working, sometimes in tandem, sometimes not, maybe occasionally across purposes, you know, but just trying to make a scene evolve and keep the music they love alive and fresh and happening, and you know, in some cases, I guess, giving it a local slant or local flavor as well. I don't know that there's ever been a definitive Syracuse blues style. You know, the Kingsnakes, again, may be what defines it for a lot of people because their records have gotten out there more than probably anyone else's, and some of the other blue wave stuff, you know, has a certain power and edge that, you know, may characterize it. But when you really, when I think about all interesting is that each one has really had its own kind of flavor, you know, even with the mixing and matching of people, you know. Each band has its own flavor, and that variety, I think, is actually, you know, part of what's kept the scene vital for so long too.
Syracuse. I've only played here a handful of times. I remember, I think Cannon's Ballroom was the first time I played here. I really loved that place. So if Hurt Cannon sees this, come on down tonight.
Thank you. just a dream. A dream I had on my mind. Yeah, just a dream. A dream I had on my mind. But when I woke up this morning, baby, not one thing could I find. Well, I dreamed I played the horses, all my horses came through. I had so much money, Lord, I didn't know what to do. It was just a dream. Just a dream I had on my mind. When I woke up this morning, Chris, I couldn't find one lousy dime. Got a few cents on the
phone. I mean, we all have our weaknesses, you know, and I just try to, you know, focus in on those little human foibles and maybe exaggerate them to some extent in some of the tunes, because, you know, the blues, among other things, seems to be about those things. You know, most of the time when we get in trouble in love or money or substance abuse or whatever, you know, it's owing to some of those you know, appetites and flaws and so forth. And you know, blues music confronts it pretty honestly and sometimes in a humorous way that I think is more purging.
To the White House, sat in old GW's chair. They all came up, they shook my head, and they said, Tom, thank God you're here. It was just a dream. Lord, don't you know, just a dream I had on my mind. Job could I find? Oh, it was just a dream.
It's just been two decades essentially of trying to immerse myself in the music in as many ways as I can as a player, you know, probably first and foremost, but also through this show.
Thank you. big old family. We had 10 children, baby, and they all looked like me. Oh, it was just a dream. I mean, it was just a dream I had on my mind. But when I woke up this morning, baby, not one child looked like mine. Just a dream, y'all.
Thank you. that we had that maybe joined the band. We took him out of his house in chains and said, you're now in the supernatural. So we're going to feature Jerry on this song here. It's an old Booker T of the MG song about one of my favorite vegetables. We'll send this out to Kelly Jennings there. It's called Green Onions. Check up on the band at www.cmyblues.com. There's some information on there about us. You can also find the CD through there. It's a very cool website, our keyboard player says. So take it to Jared. Song I wrote all about when you have to get up in the morning on Monday morning and go to work. Girl, don't you get so tired of working hard, man, every day. Girl, don't you get so tired of working hard, man, every day. Throw your troubles out the door. I've got to get insurance on my car, insurance on my wife. Oh, you can take a lot of pain.
Thank you. Thank you.
too. And it's turning down.
Oh. Sarasota Sunset. The voice of an angel, Miss Rebecca Keith, here. Yeah. Oh. Give her a warm hand. She likes a warm hand versus a cold hand.
Thank you. I'm going to serve you another drink. Leave a tip at the bar for those guys. Last call at the bar, everybody. We'd like to thank Shifties for having us back here. Don't forget, we got a brand new CD out. In your record stores, go out and get it. Turn it up. In your car, in your house, or wherever. This is an old tune by Johnny Hooker, the great Johnny Hooker. This one's called Boom Boom. I'm going to shoot you right down. everybody. Let's get all that stuff.
Yes, sir. I think that John has been having a good time.
Thank you. here on the Kingpins. We will be back next Sunday. Phil Basso on my right here, Ross Ball on the drums, Jerry Bauer on the bass, Joe Caruana, Chris Sawyer. We'll see you next Sunday.
We'll be at Alpha Lales Wednesday.